matter how we play. Yes, it's another home fixture for the St. Lucia Stars here at Groes Eylau in St. Lucia against the Guyana Amazon Warriors. These are the two teams who have not yet recorded a single victory in the 2017 Hero CPL. It's match 12 coming to you live.
Heads. Heads is a call from Martin.
Tails it is.
Tails it is. So the Stars have won the toss. Darren, what are you going
to
do?
We're going to bat to the beach.
Why is that?
I think for the last two games we've chased, I think we've no scoreboard pressure on the guys. I'm hoping that it will be a better turnout. Plus, it's a good wicket. You know, so far, the teams who've batted first, they've posted almost 200. So if we could do that, bat sensibly and give our bowlers some confidence to come back and look to defend it.
How important is it from a batting perspective to get one of your top three getting a significant score?
It's very important. You know, in any format of the game, you need partnerships, and somebody in the top four has to bat through. You know, it's only 20 overs. With that said, you know, we've had Fletcher at the top, who's batted really well, gotten the stats, and wickets keep falling around him. So, you know, if we could be a little bit more smart, a little smarter today, and play some good positive cricket in the process, I believe we could be victorious.
The umpires are Johan Klote of South Africa and Leslie Rifa Jr. of Barbados. Yeah, Leslie, if only, if you turn back the clock, you could get a few outswingers going here today.
Well, funnily enough, I'm seeing the Warriors slightly coming into this contest with a slight advantage, purely on the back of, as I mentioned in the pre-game show, really unusual. Most teams tend to, you know, own their own home ground, and you know, it's like a fortress to them. But the Stars have found it difficult, not only this year but in previous years, to really get that success at home. So let's hope for their sake they can turn it around here tonight. But the Warriors, I feel that given they've had an extra day or two's rest,
no Stephen Jacobs, and I just wonder if it's a tactical move or whether he's picked up some sort of injury. No left-handed batsman in the top four.
Such a high price in white ball cricket. It's a free hit and it can turn a match very easily.
Play time, says Leslie Rifa Jr. Tanvir. Inside out from Fletcher, not sure that he hit it as well as he would have wanted to, but he's hit it well enough for four.
Well, one thing that Fletcher's done well
over. Well, legs up line, nudged around the corner, delicate from Charles, and Tanvir gives up the chase easily.
Yeah, this time.
Oh, nice. First hero maximum of the contest goes to Andre Fletcher.
He's got a clear plan. When the ball's up, it's going. As simple as that.
Ah! Yeah!
Gone.
That's all this.
Beaten for pace, Andre Fletcher, and a simple catch for Martin Guptill. And Jason Mohammed will be smiling. That's one way to do it. It's a pitch that responds to effort here at the Darren Sammy Stadium. Andre Fletcher goes for 13. It's 22 for 1. Charles on strike. In the air, down to backward square. And a boundary. So the short ball worked once, this one not as high, and put away.
It was a very controlled shot. He picked up the length really well.
Oh, that's gone! My goodness, into the Johnson Charles stand, named after him.
There it is, right back into that one. A huge block. Oh my golly gosh, that has gone out of the venue. A car park delivery shot, it's gone.
Sunshine snacks, not power shot.
In the air. Should be out. Keeper under it. No mistake. So an El Dorado celebration for Emirates. The good and the bad so far this over.
Well, he was undone by the ball before. It was a beauty from Emirates that maybe sowed the seed of doubt into Samuel's mind. And it was a shot without conviction. Walton takes the steepling catch. Samuel's gone for two, 43 for two.
Oh, Shane Watson, beautiful full face and timing. That's a boundary.
50 comes up for the St. Lucia Stars and comes up with a classy shot from Shane Watson.
In the air, hasn't quite got it, but there's going to be enough on it. Yes! I think you'll see that's a six. It may have landed on the full. Well, this is more like
six more. He's really got a great bat and it's making a lovely sound for the St. Lucia Stars and their fans.
Well, slow pace delivery.
It's gone again. He really is pummeling this attack and it's great to watch if you're wearing blue and yellow. That's his fourth six of the night. Good place to stack him up. And he's going to get four more here. And it's 50 for Johnson Charles in 29 balls. And it's been such an entertaining innings this. Oh, it's gone a long way up. Who wants it? Who wants it? Babar Azam takes a steepling catch. And Rashid Khan has his first wicket on this Hero CPL. He's threatened all through the campaign, and finally he's got one.
Yeah, relief for Rashid Khan. It's how the drinks break.
Third man inside the ring, it's four. That's the risk you take when you bring him up from there.
Not exactly where Watson would have liked to have hit it, but he gets the desired amount of runs. Pace off delivery again, just rolling his fingers, leg cut up, and gets a thickish outside edge. But just on Sammy. Is he the
done him again. I think that's deliberate from Shane Watson, and it brings up the 100 for the St. Lucia Stars. It's come in the 12th over. Gone! Cameron Akmal, what have you done again? He doesn't work it out, and it's been a wretched CPL for the Pakistan banner. He's gone for two from four, and that's yet another blow struck. And Rashid Khan has picked up his second. Akmal, gone again, cheaply, 204 for four. Has he connected? No, he hasn't. Martin Guptill takes the catch. They're just going to check the height of this delivery.
Well, both Darren Sammy and Shane Watson looked straight away to square leg, but we're going to have to look at the front foot first. That's fine. Rock and roll it through to the next. And that looks like a line ball, so this angle will be much better. Yeah, I think he's out, but I've got plenty wrong before.
And remember, it's taken from the batsman standing upright at the crease, so Watson is a little crouched in that position, so that's the right decision being made. Watson is gone, wicket's tumbling, and from a good start, the Stars are just faltering here. Watson 32, 108 for five.
pace, and pace off the bat, finds the fielder, simply done by Primus. And Fletcher, Mayers has got to go, Carl Mayers. Babrazam takes his second catch of the evening. Didn't have to do much than watch it go straight into his hands. Mayers goes for a duck.
Put one. Up in the air. And very well controlled by the big man, Rakeem Cornwall. Full pace of the bat, 1-2-2 for six. Would have been a wide, but instead it's tucked away through the offside. That almost well done. Well, we'll have to look at it again by Veerasamy Pomal.
Yeah, ball being bowled into the wicket was certainly going to be a wide. Rakeem Cornwall does well to get it to there. And oh, it's hard to tell, isn't it, whether the ball is touching the boundary rope. So the ball, yeah, so it's touched his leg whilst his leg is touching the rope. So it'll be given four.
Gone for six. Sammy will say, well, I've had some revenge in this over. It's cool as you like. Lot of height and over the boundary into the wind there, so it didn't carry as far but carried enough. No doubt about that, Darren Sammy is lighting up his own building.
Well, it went into...
Not hit that one, he's not hit it well enough. And taken by Roshan Primus. 2 sixes and then his wicket goes down. Twenty-six to Darren Sammy, 149 for seven. Another one goes down. Easy catch for Rashid Khan.
There seems to be a question with how Rashid Khan took the ball. Or there is confusion. Yeah, the umpires are saying, what are you hanging around for? So Cornwall gone for 14, it's 149 for 8. Really good performance by Rashid Khan. Has been wicketless in the CPL, but picked up 2 wickets and only went for 9 runs. We started to see this pitch turn sharply and also with a bounce. So there's still plenty in it for the bowlers. So 152, if St. Lucia Stars bowl well, bowl to their field, then certainly it's going to be one that will go down to the wire. So St. Lucia won the toss and elected to bat, and Johnston Charles was electric out at the top, 53 off 32. Shane Watson played his second game, perform well, 32, and Darren Sammy again in the runs. As for the bowlers, Ryan Emirat was on a hat-trick, 4 for 35, and we've already mentioned Rashid Khan, 2 for 9.
The Nestle countdown, which is not to say the Warriors aren't desperate either. Play can the Stars bowl with greater discipline tonight. Walton. It's a good delivery to start with, to bring Alan Wilkins into the chair.
lofted over mid-on. Adventurous shot, and he gets the reward of four. Short picked up, and it's six big ones, Hero Maximum. Short ball punished. Looking for that full Yorker length, and he's clipped this nicely for four. Andre Fletcher can't prevent it going over that boundary cushion.
Well, Walton's race to 18 now with two fours and a six. Taylor looking for that Yorker, but just getting it fractionally full. That's beautifully timed. Fletcher fielded particularly well.
Taylor, that's still a little bit full, and it's been punished. Full blade of the bat, four straight past the bowler.
Yeah, excellent. And one of the things I like about Walton in this edition of the CPL is the tempo at which he's scoring.
Leading edge, and he gets away with it. Shillingford was the fielder, and the bowler's going to feel very aggrieved with that. It's punished, it's gone for four. Well, it might have been a difficult chance, but from a bowling perspective, Mitch McLennan would be tearing his hair out here, and he's got a fair lock of it as well. He's just taken the pace off that, the slight sort of cutter delivery. Well, I think Shillingford moves slowly to this. Yeah, you've got to stop that. You've got to stop that going past you.
Leading edge and taken. Good catch, James Shillingford. And Jerome Taylor comes back into the attack and has immediate effect.
Looking to work to the leg side. Leading edge just ballooning down to short third man, where Shane Shillingford was waiting. It was a good catch. Walton goes, he was good for 33. It's 39 for one.
No one's catching that. That's typical Martin Guptill. Hero Maximum.
He's known for how well he hits the ball straight down the ground. This one, he didn't quite get the timing, but it was good enough. Sammy was sort of living in hope that that may have just fallen inside.
Providing so much for him as well.
Straight away he strikes. Babarazam fails again, but Shillingford, more importantly, is struck with the second ball he served up in this contest. Stars needed this.
Looking to work it to the leg side, just getting through the shot too early, getting that leading edge and ballooning a simple catch back to Shillingford. He's continuing his good form. Babarazam not continuing any form. He goes for 12, 64 for two.
Good bounce, but really well played as well by Guptill. Just rode with the bounce and just managed to get it down to that vacant third area. And he's there asking the square leg umpire, surely that's one for the over.
Shillingford. Again, down to that area at third man, just like Guptill did. This time it's Mohammed.
I feel really sorry for Shane Shillingford because this isn't a poor delivery. Turns, it bounces, it's over middle stump.
It's a lovely shot. Lovely indeed from Jason Mohammed. I talk about him as a good player of spin and so good square at the wicket either side.
Well, it's because of the two shots down to third.
Now, has he caught hold of this? I don't think he has. Oh, what a good catch. Marlon Samuels. That is a very, very good catch. He looks very calm and collected there, but they are difficult. Martin Guptill. It's gone big, gone down the ground, and Hero Maximum. Nice clean blow from Jason Muhammad.
Onto the boundary.
Oh, that's a good shot. That is four runs. Jason Muhammad with impeccable timing.
Action. Oh, yeah. I wonder if he got an edge to that. And he did. That's why Shillingford was annoyed, because Cameron Akmal didn't catch it, nor did he stop it.
The complexion of this run chase. Gajanan Singh collects a Hero Maximum. It's a tasty blow from the left-hander. And this is just deflating the spirits of St. Lucia.
In the air, and big enough. So there's the Hero Maximum going over deep backward square.
Problems for Andre Fletcher, he's got an ice pack around that right arm. Meanwhile, Gajanan Singh with a flick. And he's got enough on this, and in fact that is against the breeze that Tom Moody's talking about.
Glorious from Gajanan. He is playing a lovely cameo, 26 from 14.
Well, there's a deep cover in place, but that cover is very, very square because of the width that Taylor's bowling, but Gajanan Singh has got a good full face on that and lifted it over extra cover. Terrific cricketing stroke.
Well struck again from Gajanan. This is a golden innings. The true warrior.
Huge delivery right here. Is it gone? It's gone. Darren Sammy gets his big hands around that white ball and the skipper plucks it out of the air. Is there a twist here?
Muscle and four. Even into the wind, Primus gets it away. And the Warriors can see light at the end of a tunnel. Not over yet.
Yeah, nice flick to the leg side. Just a little bit short of what he was looking for, Sammy. He was searching for that leg stump Yorker.
Could get two. They will get two. They come back for two. And it's victory for the Amazon Warriors with one ball to spare here at the Darren Sammy Stadium. It was tense, it was close, but Roshan Primus and Gajanan Singh have seen it across the line. The Warriors win by 6 wickets. Just double checking that runner, but he was home by a long way.
So clearly not out. Such an important game for both teams who hadn't recorded a win before this evening. And it's the Warriors, the Amazon Warriors, that are ones that will be leaving this venue this evening with a smile on their face. Frustration continues with the form of Darren Sammy's team, the Stars.
Number of what-ifs
They started so well with the bat, the Stars, and should have gotten about 180. It was tight for Roshan Primus. This will do him the world of good.
Oh dear. Oh, heartbreak. Well, that's going to hurt. That's now 5 defeats out of 5 for the St. Lucia Stars, and Ghana Amazon Warriors win their first, and it's taken them 4 matches to do it. Rashid, 4 overs, 16 dot balls, 2 for 9. Rashid Khan was brilliant. Was really outstanding for the Warriors.
Gajanan Singh, very good as well. Not out 35. Well, it was close. They say they were getting close over Stars, but they just couldn't get over the line. 153 for 4, the Warriors. Walton, 33. 38 to Jason Muhammad as well. And 35 to Gajanan Singh, not out of just 22 deliveries.
McLennigan up front was good. Taylor, excellent again, getting a breakthrough. And Mayers, 4 overs, 1 for 22 for him. Shillingford looked like he was going to cause some problems, but is expensive, going for 41.